Adam Gase takes over as GM, flips Darron Lee to the Chiefs for a sixth-round pick. Reportedly, this had been in the works for a while. It wasn't just Adam took the reins and pulled the trigger on a trade, I don't think.
The way you want to.
I know you got into some discussion online about Darron Lee, and his grade was good, and you're saying he's not great in coverage. So context is king when it comes to all this stuff. Last year, he was a top five coverage grade at linebacker, but when we look at linebacker coverage grades, the multi-year sample is the most important part of this thing.
So, yeah, there was a comment somewhere in the thing that the Chiefs believe Darron Lee to be one of the best coverage linebackers in all of football. Now, my comment was, maybe if your standards start with Anthony Hitchens and Reggie Ragland, you might believe that, but if your standards actually include any other linebackers, that would appear to be crazy. And then people's comments was, well, he was top five by Pro Football Focus last year. You saying your own grades don't matter?
No, we're
the point is no.
Like, we're saying multiple years of grading.
Right. Well, not
matters.
Even multiple. So dive deeper than that, right? The whole point is, if you use one number for anything, it's silly. Use more than one number. Stick with the grades if you want. I don't care if you want to. You don't need to fold stats into this to make the argument. The number last year was driven essentially by two extremely highly graded games, and the rest of his season didn't suck as much as the previous two seasons sucked in coverage.
Well, the rest of his season was solid. So.
Right. So those two grades pulled up an otherwise solid season to look a lot better than it was. Now, the complaint some people have was, why would two games be able to warp a grade that much? Now, part of this is because he was suspended four games. So it's not 2 out of 16, it's 2 out of 12,
right,
which is a lot easier to warp. And two, because the baseline outside of that wasn't as bad as it had been in previous seasons, right? The 2 years prior to that, his grades were in the 40s for coverage. So you've got like 1 year in the 40s, 2 year in the 40s. Then you've got year three, which is a little higher. The baseline is, 50, 60s. And then two outstanding grades that pull that up a little bit. Now, if you want to look at just last year and the high grade, because driven by those two really good games, I think you get fed a misrepresentation of what the broader context shows, which is a guy that has 2 years of terrible grading, 1 year of okay grading, and then two outstanding games. To me, if you're looking at what that would produce in 2019, you're still ending up below average at best.
So it's the nature of numbers, though, Sam, is part of it. It's not, so I don't think it's a knock on the system as much as it's the nature of numbers. Okay, so we said that there were two great games that skewed things, mm-hmm. right? And the rest of it was solid. It was good. I mean,
yeah, take out those two games, his grade is 60-something for coverage.
Let's use Mitch Trubisky as an example here. His passer rating last year was 94, okay? Mm-hmm. If you take out his top two games,
you're
which
were...
You're
already pissing off Bears fans, by
I know.
The way.
I Remember just always
they,
have to
They hated
link
when
you
did
back.
This the last time.
Trubisky, if you take out those top two games, which did occur.
They did.
But you take them out, mm-hmm. six touchdown game against Tampa Bay and a great game against the Detroit Lions, where he had a passer rating above 150 and above 148 or whatever it was, he drops down to 84. So it drops 10 points, okay? In just those weeks, that ranks 30th. In the NFL. The 94, though, where does that rank in the NFL? Let me see here. Going back. I should have started with this one.
Yeah.
The 94 ranked 17th. So he goes from 17th to 30th. And this is a guy that played 16 games and has, 500-plus attempts. So there's a large data point. And this is just an example of numbers, okay? So even quarterbacks who have a much larger sample size than, say, linebackers in coverage, much larger sample size, using a stat like passer rating, two games can skew a guy from 17th to 30th, just as an example. So part of it is just the way numbers work. Mm-hmm. So you have to understand the context behind where this stuff came through. The analysis for Darron Lee is he had two straight years of coverage in the 40s, and then last year was a top five or six player. So you could say, okay, he took a step forward. That's great. Maybe he's turning the corner. But you do still have to use that bigger sample size and say, well, his three-year coverage grade is actually 54.1.
Yeah.
That is 45th out of 54 linebackers with at least 100 targets. 45 out of 54. That's probably a truer number than what we just saw from last year. And this is one thing we try to do here at PFF is to tell you, even though we're putting out these grades, it's a one-year number, and there's always more context available.
And I don't think there's anything wrong with this idea. So all those Bears fans get mad because you say, well, if you take out these two games from Trubisky, he sucked, right? They're like, well, why would you take him out? They happened. He was amazing. You're like, fair. Absolutely fair. So let's not take away the two games that Darron Lee was spectacular last year. Let's include them in and say, last year, largely driven off two spectacular games, Darron Lee had a top five coverage grade among linebackers. So last year, he was really good. Right. Largely, but you have to understand, one, it was largely driven off two games, which is a bigger sample size sort of warper for him because he only played 12. But two, we don't care about last year anymore. What we're looking to try and do is say in 2019 and 20 and 21, what is Darron Lee likely to be? And then you ask yourself, is he more likely to be the player that turned up in two games and was spectacular, or the player that was terrible for 2 years before that, or somewhere in the middle, which is a guy who graded a baseline of 60 last year and had his grade pulled up by two games?
Well, there's a couple other things at play. We were just talking about Patrick Peterson getting suspended.
Uh-huh.
Darron Lee got suspended for four games for...
Yes.
For whatever he did.
Yeah. Early in the season, he had two really good games. Later in the season, he's suspended for 4 weeks for PEDs.
So you actually have to step back and say, okay, he has 2 years in the 40s in coverage, and then one good year in the year that he got suspended. Okay, so who's the real Darron Lee? How long has he been doing this? All that stuff. All of that said, from the Chiefs' perspective, giving up a sixth-round pick to take a shot at improving your coverage unit at linebacker is fine. I have no problem with that.
It's a sixth-round pick. Who cares?
Right? So it's a more nuanced conversation than you getting attacked and attacking back with your Twitter followers. Not a bad move by the Chiefs. There's no guarantee that he's going to be another top five coverage linebacker again. And who the heck is Darron Lee anyway? He got suspended last year.
My point is simply that if you like believing that he's already a top coverage linebacker in the NFL would seem to be silly. And the fact that he graded top five last year for us does not counter that argument.
Right.
Because if you look beyond that one number and look at the same grades across a different period of time, or even just break them down on a game-by-game basis, you still would come away with significant question marks that he is a top five player in the NFL, even if he graded that way over 12 games.
He kicked off the season with an excellent two-interception, one-pass breakup game against the Detroit Lions, where Matthew Stafford was quite horrendous.
Yeah.
He also broke up two passes in the Vikings game. It's kind of the nature of the linebacker position. In general, you can have some high-end games like that that might skew things a little bit. It's the nature of that, but as I mentioned, the Trubisky example, that can happen.